आददानं दन्ते स्थीनं इदं जाचे पुनः पुनः श्रीमदरूपपदाम्बुजधूलि स्वांग जन्म जन्मनि आददानं स्थीनं आददानं स्थीनो दन्तैरिदं जाचे पुनः पुनः श्रीमदरूपपदाम्बुजधूलि स्वांग जन्म जन्मनि गौड़ीय गोष्ठीपति श्रीशील भक्ति सिद्धांत सरस्वती गोस्वामी ठाकुर प्रभुपाद जगद्गुरु टोल्ड दोज वर एट ऑल गेटिंग द टेस्ट ऑफ अनन्य भजन गौड़ीय गोष्ठीपति श्रीशील भक्ति सिद्धांत सरस्वती गोस्वामी ठाकुर प्रभुपाद जगद्गुरु टोल्ड दोज वर एट ऑल गोइंग टू गेट द टेस्ट ऑफ अनन्य भजन देयर इज नो डेंजर फॉर देम If at all they are going to get the taste of Ananya Bhajan, then there is as such no great problem for them. Ananya Bhajan is not a matter of joke. And on those days I was discussing about Vidhi Bhakti, Vaidhi Bhakti and Raganuga Bhakti etc. and different kind of impediments in between. There can be so many problems. I want to discuss more clearly. Actually, Gaudiya Goshtipati Bhakti Siddhanta Saraswati Goswami Thakur Prabhupada speaking that Krishna Seva aprakito deher karjo. It means Bengali, Krishna Seva is a subject matter of aprakita deha. With material deho, nobody can serve Krishna. Krishna Seva is a matter of aprakita deho. Is a matter of aprakita deho seva. Krishna Seva can be done by the application of aprakita deho, aprakita sarir. External, if somebody going to attribute something and try to conceive some Siddha Sarup inside body, Antas Chintita Kalpanik, you know, that mental, because mind is also material, so it is by the application of this material mind, if somebody like to do seva, this kind of seva, those Goswami Pad never told. Goswami Gam, Those Goswamis, they never told us to do seva this way because we know already seva sadhaka rupena siddha rupena chatrahi tadbhava lipshu karya brujo lokanusaratha. I mean two fold of bhakti we can find. One is by the application of external body and after that and internally, you can have siddha-bhav, siddha-sarir. With this, you can mentally, you have to do it, manas-seva. That manas-seva is not material manas-seva. When total body, mind, everything become transcendental aprakita, everything become aprakita, then mind automatically become aprakita. And then, in that case, two type of devotional practice you can go on doing. One is externally by the help of your Bahya Antar. It's written, Krishna Das Kaviraj Goswami, Bahya Antar Ihar Duito Sadhan, Bajhe Sadhak Dehe Kare Savan Kirtan, Mane Nijo Shiddho Deho Koriya Bhavan. It is written in Chaitanya Charitamrita that this sadhan is two type of sadhana. One is by external sadhak deho, shavan kirtan adi, under the guidance of pure Guru Vaishnava, can go on doing. And inside mind, the mind is aprakita mind. Be careful. That mind, mani nijo siddha deho, koriya bhavan. Bhavan mean you think mentally concocted idea, not that. Prabhupada speaking, actually by the application of this gross body and subtle body, aprakita vastur seva hoyena. It is not possible. It is not possible to serve Krishna aprakita vastu, because you know already, aprakita vastu kabu prakita gochanai. Aprakita vastu, transcendental object, aprakita harinam, aprakita dham, aprakita lila, all you cannot understand, you cannot even touch. Impossible, inconceivable, not possible. So actually, by the application of this subtle body and by the application of this, gross body, one cannot serve any aprakita vastu, transcendental object, dham, nam, parikar, vaishishtra, anything, leela, I cannot serve. Actually, by the application of aprakita deho, by the application of aprakita sarir, body, aprakita vastu, seva can be done. Prabhupada speaking, when your body, mind, everything become totally transcendental, and by the application of your body, and you know already, many times I told, Sanatana Goswami speaking, when you are hearing Harikatha from heart continuously like mad, then you can automatically, very shortly, you can automatically forget your body and body related thing, your body, mind, etc. become transcendental. That's why I like to remind you that thing, Krishna Bhakti Sudha Panat, Krishna Bhakti Sudha Panat, Amrita Nictar of Harikatha, Krishna Bhakti Sudha Panat, Deho Dahiko Visrite. When you can forget your body and body related thing, and tesam, for them only, this externally you can find their body is made up of five elements of nature, but not that. Their body become aprakita dehe avirbhav, appear, aprakita deha. You cannot see. Material people cannot see externally, but it's a must. So Prabhupada speaking, by the application of aprakita deha and mind, aprakita seva can be done that time. And when you are doing seva, then the symptom, some reaction, some symptom, some different kind of symptom can be seen in the body. And baiha dehe ta spandan. Spandan actually, to be frank, I am very disgusted, because actually those terms written in Sanskrit and Bengali, it is impossible to translate into English. Not possible. There is no such word. No such word. But somehow forcefully I am doing. Anyway, to give indication, actually spandan, actually you can give, spandan mean in English vibration, but I cannot use this. Spandan mean you can see, the symptoms can be seen in external. Prabhupada writing this way, because aprakito, prakito man, material mind is always failure. Material mind is always failure. You can try with your material mind to do bhajan without getting full kippa of Guru Vaishnava, or maybe you are not going to take shelter of Guru Vaishnava. Perfect. Submission is not there anyway. In that case, we know from Upanishad Shruti that yato vacho nivartante aprappa manasa saha. Your mind can fade up and come back, totally failure. So, which is beyond our speech and mind and bodily conception, that object is aprakita. And that aprakita seva only can be done. There is one condition written in Rupa Goswami Pada, clearly speaking about this, when you can get the privilege, when you can get the privilege, chance, privilege, to serve aprakita dham, aprakita bhagavan, how? Srila Rupa Goswami Pad clearly speaking in Rasamrita Sindhu, Ataha, yetu this material, this aprakita, dham, nam, so it is beyond our material conception. So, Ataha, Krishna Amadi, na bhavet grajya mendriyai, sevan mukhehi yuvayam adau swayameva spurti ada. Rupa Goswami Pad writing in Rasamrita Sindhu, this is beyond our, you know, thinking, inconceivable. So, we cannot buy your material body, mind and speech, we cannot touch it, impossible. Yato vacho nivartante aprapa manasa saho. Mind can fade up, our speech can fade up and come back. Failure, totally. So, that's why Rupa Goswami is speaking, ataha, that's why, Krishna namadi, here Krishna nam, Krishna Amadi na bhavet grajyavindu. That's why Rupa Goswami Pad giving clear conception that Krishna Nam Adi mean Krishna Nam, Krishna Roop, Krishna Leela, Krishna Vaishishto, anything, Krishna, everything, anything. You know, Krishna Nam Adi, Adi mean etc. Adi mean etc. Ataha Krishna Nam Adi. Arthat, that is why Krishna Nam, etc. I mean Krishna Nam, Krishna Lila, Krishna Dham, Krishna Parikar, Krishna Vaishishto, Krishna Roop, Krishna, anything. It is not possible for us to understand, to realize by the help of material sense organs and mind. Because mind is, mind, you cannot see your mind. I know Maharaj, mind is sense organ. And Maharaj, five external sense organ, antarindriya, bahirindriya, or five external sense organ, five internal sense organ. But mind is the leader of all, boss. Mind is the boss of all. When your mind is not going to do any cooperation with any action you are supposed to do, you are going to do, then your action is not complete. Because mind, you are not going to get the cooperation of your mind. So mind is a must. So mind is so strong, that if you are going to stay mentally in Navadvip Dhyan, then your Dambas is perfect. And if you are going to stay in Navadvip Dhyan or Vrindavan Dham physically, but mentally you are absent, your mind is somewhere else. In that case, your dambas is totally failure. That's why our Gosai Path speaking, if at all not possible to stay physically, physically mean physically and mentally. Physically mean doesn't mean physically only, not mental. Physically mean Gosai Path wanted to speak that if possible physically and mentally, or if not possible physically, then at least mentally. You have to stay continuously. And mind is the boss of all sense organ. That's why, you know, it's written, Ataha Krishna Namadi na bhavet grajyam indriyai. Our material mind, sense organ, everything cannot touch. Grajyam indriyam, we can realize how and when. But their only condition, the only condition written is there, when seven mukhehi jivayam, when my sense organ and mind want to do some seva, become busy, feeling some inspiration to do some seva, in that case, seven mukhehi jivayam, when your sense organ, mind, everything become very interested to do serve your, you know, parikram, do, you know, kirtan, harikatha, sravan, everything. When you are going to, when you are feeling inspiration to do it, then seven mukh, when become, you know, eager to serve, in that case, automatically your tongue can utter the name of Aprakita Harinam. Seven mukhehi jivayam adau. Adau means at all. At all when you are going to show some serving mood, then automatically you can find your tongue, in your tongue, Harinam, Hare Krishna, dancing, you know. That's why yesterday I also told the Siddhanta Vichara of Radharani. Radharani wanted to speak in front of Krishna in Kurukshetra. That other people, for other people, their mind is staying somewhere and they are speaking something, their mind is somewhere, but it is, but my mind is not like that. There is no space, the entire mind. My entire mind is full of Vrindavan. Aner hidray mon, mor mon Vrindavan, mone bone ek kori mani. I already told yesterday. So when your total mind, there is no space, no gapping of any matter to come and take entry, and no space. In that case, it's okay. Those who are actual Raganuga devotee, because I started with this sloka, you know, very humble mood, you know. This is why Narottama Thakur singing in Kirtan, that I cannot do bhajan, I am my pain, my condition is very, very painful. See, I am going to die without Krishna bhajan. Narottama Thakur writing in Kirtan, Vishayo Vishama Visha Satato Khainu. Vishayo Vishama Visha Satato Khainu. Gaura Kirtana Rase Magano Nahainu. Keno Vayachoye Pran Kishukho Lagiya. Narottama Daso Keno Nagelo Moriya. Vishaya Visham Mijo. Vishaya means the matter. Matter is really poison, more than poison. Vishaya Visham Visheshatato Khainu. Narottama Thakur speaking, Vishaya Visham Visheshatato Khainu. I am always, you know, taking the test of matter, Vishaya Visham, Satato, continuously, non-stop. But still, I am not going to grow any detachment. This is my condition. And Gaura Kirtana Rase, I am not feeling any inspiration. My mind is not going to take the nectarian, you know, Harikatha Kirtan. Gaura Kirtana Rase Magana Nama, I am not busy with Gaura Kirtan Ras. Still today I am busy with matter, all the time. That's why Narottama ultimately going to cry and speaking, you know, humbly, very humble mood. Balo, why my body going to, why I am going to leave? Kenova ache man kishu ko lagaya. Kenova ache pran kishu ko lagaya. What for? What for I am going to leave? What is the reason? Narottama Thakur speaking, for what reason I am leaving? To get what test? Ki test? What bliss? What sukha? Happiness? I am living? Why Narottama Das not going to die? This painful situation? Narottama Thakur speaking this way. Also, you can remember the sloka written by Rupa Goswami Pad. I will have to discuss all in details, but I am not feeling comfortable because so vast chapter, also so deep thing, within this short compass, it's impossible to, you know, to represent or how I can make you feel. Yes, I'm trying my best. It is written that, in Rupa Goswami Pad, Utsaha Nischat Dajjat Tat Tat Karma Pavartanat, this sloka, you have to understand very clearly. Rupa Goswami Pad, Upadashamrita, if we cannot understand, it is quite impossible for us to, you know, realize. So this way actually, so Nitya Siddha Krishna Prem Sadhagubuna, we are Rai Ramananda going to speak in front of Mahaprabhu, there is actually Prem Bhakti. But Prem Bhakti, there is a diversity, so different kind of diversity there. Also, I was discussing yesterday, Tattad Bhavadi Madhurje Srute Dhiryat Apikshate Natro Shastro Na Yuktincha Tat Lobhatpatti Lakshanam. To grow loha, greed, bhava, attraction, Shastra Yukti, no need. It's an automatic. After hearing, if you can feel tremendous attraction for that Raganuga Bhajan, then you can. Maybe it is perfect. You will have to get it tested. You will have to get it tested by pure Guru Vaishnava. They can clearly speak. Otherwise, not possible. Bhaktivinoda Thakur, under the guidance of Bhaktivinoda Thakur, Bhakti Siddhanta Saraswati Goswami Thakur speaking. Because many, we are in confusion about Sarv Siddhi, Vastu Siddhi, and how to get mentally concocted idea somebody giving. So what Prabhupada speaking, I must discuss. Prabhupada speaking, in course of doing pure Harinam, as a procedure through which you can get entry. At all if you are getting reaction, at all if you are going to get, you know, reaction, I mean attraction inside her. In that case, Prabhupada speaking, in course of doing Sri Harinam with full, you know, appealing mood, if you go on doing Harinam mood in course of your Harinam, you know, some special things, some special matters can come, can give you some information. Try to understand. In course of your continuous Harinam with appealing mood, automatically you can know something, automatically can come inside your heart. You can get some identity, you can get some information. Many such examples I can give you. I was in Surya Kunda there by the mercy of Guru Patwan Prabhupada. Then Madhusudan Das Babaji Maharaj, he heard from somebody that without knowing Siddha Sarup Parichay, information about Siddha Sarup, my bhajan is all failure. I cannot do bhajan. Then he was crying and crying. One day he is, you know, growing so detachment, so painful situation. He thinking that I heard without any information about Siddha Sarup, how I can do bhajan? Then all my bhajan is failure. Then he jumped into Surya Kund. After that, the same case with Krishnadas Babaji Maharaj also, Siddha Krishnadas in Manasi Ganga also. After that, you know, Madhusudan Babaji Maharaj going to get information. That is, going to get information that this is your sorrow. This is a miracle, automatic by the mercy of Radharani, Radharani's Guru. So, Prabhupada speaking, in course of doing Harinam by the guidance of a pure Sadhu Guru Vaishnava, pure Sadhu Guru Vaishnava, repeatedly I am speaking. If your Gurudev is perfect Sadguru, then by the guidance of that Sadguru, if you go on doing Harinam continuously, from heart, with appealing mood, then automatically you are going to get some secret information. Prabhupada speaking, that is called your identity of your Sarup. Prabhupada speaking, this is collected your identity of your Sarup. Artificial you cannot get. Now Prabhupada speaking, when anartha, I can discuss all in detail today very, very slowly because, you know, question of realization here, na? Anartha nibriti haile, Prabhupada speaking, when anartha get vanished, when all your anartha get vanished, then sarup manifest. Prabhupada speaking, when all your anartha get vanished, then in that case, sarup get manifested. And when your Swarup get manifested, Swarupe Rudbodhane, your Nitya Priti, your eternally attraction, Seva, even I cannot use this, you know, Priti, this word, and after that, you know, Prema. This Prema I cannot translate, by love. It is totally prohibited. Because Prema, in love is not the exact translation of Prema. Because by love you can get some material conception. So it's impossible. Still, by the mercy of Bhaktivinoda Prabhupada, I'm trying so that I can realize myself something, I can help you to realize something. Prabhupada speaking, when Sarup is get, when your Nitya Sarup get manifested, then your Nitya Priti, your eternal, you know, Priti, loveful affair, Priti, automatically you can feel inside your heart. Or externally, artificially, nobody can help you to get that kind of siksha, teachings. Prabhupada speaking, Uha kahake kapatata kuriya siksha dayana, ninnaya kuriya dayana. Prabhupada speaking, artificially, nobody, externally, nobody can help you to get this kind of teachings. Not possible. But without any duplicity, if you go on doing Harinam and Harinam, Harinam, discovered Chidhana, the kind of realization, the kind of special realization you feel inside your heart, automatically you can get some secret information. In that case, you will have to go to your Sadguru, who is, you know, Raganuga Guru. You will have to secretly inform only Guru. Because Nathamata was speaking, Apan bhajan katha na kohibe jatha tatha. Your secrecy of your bhajan, any information you are getting in dream, anything, don't try to express in front of outside people. If you express, you can lose your bhajan. So only and only you will have to express your mood that in dream something came like this in front of pure Guru Vishnu, I mean Gurudev or Shikha Guru Diksha Guru, pure. So, if you are going to get some secret information in dream or somehow in course of doing your Harina, then you will have to approach it, your Sadguru, or if Sadguru gone, then Shikha Guru, who is perfect Shikha Guru, having full love for your Diksha Guru and also having deep foundation of bhakti, deep realization. Sabde parichani snatam brahmani upasamasrayam. He is totally absorbing mood in seva. He will have to speak secretly about your feeling, what you feel. Then you will have to get it supported by Guru. Prabhupada speaking, what secret information you are getting already in course of your, you know, Harinam from heart, without any duplicity, with full craving mood. In that case, what kind of secret information you are going to get? You will have to approach a pure Guru Vishnu and get it confirmed by him. If some idiot guru going to impose artificially, going to impose some artificial factors, because I can discuss gradually, because Raya Ramana Sangha was not a matter of joke. Raya Ramana Sangha is not a matter of joke. Bhaktivinoda Thakur from Ujjal Nilmani wanted to represent in Harinam Chintavani, Jaiva Dharma, all secret information that there is 11 type of, you know, identity you will have to get. Ekadash Prakar Bhav, Bhava, 11 different. I am going to just touch it for your kind information. That is what is your Sambandha Gyan. What is your Sambandha? Basic Sambandha Gyan, when you took Diksha from Gurudev, basic Sambandha Gyan, you got that Jive Sarupa Krishna Nitya Das. You are the servant of Krishna, that is the basic thing. And this Sambandha means you are going to eternally, what is your relation with Krishna, and what seva, particular seva you have, what is your age, what is your name, what is your beauty, figure, you know, what is your group, yutha, what is your dress, what is your special, you know, special order on you, which way you will have to do seva, you know, and what is your, where you are staying, I can discuss, where you are staying, what is your, you know, place of staying, what is your special particular seva, and what is your tenacity, deep attraction, you know, parakashta and pallodasi bhav. You are being controlled and governed by some pallodasi bhav, like Narottama Raghu writing in Kirtan, Prabhu loko nato kabe more laiya jabe sirupero pad padme more samarpibe. Follow what I say. Prabhu loko nato kabe more laiya jabe sirupero pad padme more samarpibe. Heno ki hoibe more Narmo shokhi gane anugato narottame karibe shashone. Actually Narottama Thakur, out of his deep feeling, he is going to express his own feeling. Narottama Thakur speaking that when Prabhu Loknath can ultimately catch me in my hand and approach Rupa Gosai and speak this my, you know, near and dear one, I like to offer this, you know, unto your lotus feet. Prabhu Loknath kabe more laiya jabe. When Loknath can take me and offer me unto the lotus feet of Rupa Goswami Pad, I am waiting for that day. Because our target is Srimad Rupa Pada Padambuja Dhuli Sangyanvaya. After that, Narottama Thakur is going to express the mood. Can I get this kind of luck? Unique luck, which is impossible. Hanoki haive more, norma shokhi gane. He is himself champak. No, Manjari actually is Sharu. So Narottama Thakur is going to speak. Can I get this kind of scope and advantage, facility? That this kind of luck can I get in my life so that Narma Shakhi gone, Narma Shakhis, they can come and get control over me. Hey, you have to do this way. Anugata Narottame Karibe Shashane. Anugata man who is having full submission unto the Shakhi Manjaris and they can get control over me, can chide me, they can teach me. Can I get this kind of luck? So Prabhupada is going to give information, right information, that externally some idiot guru can attribute some sarup parichay identity like sammanda, bias, and also very easy. If you can pay 500 rupees in Radha Kunda and their Sahaja Babajis, they can give you. Very 500 rupees, very cheap you can get. But Prabhupada speaking, then this sarup parichay, this way you cannot get. Bhaktivinoda Thakur, under the guidance of Bhaktivinoda Prabhupada speaking this way. But we know it for sure from Jaiva Dharma, sometimes some miracle can happen. You know the case of Vaishnav Das, who came from Harida, from Varanasi. You can remember, who coming from Varanasi, he was Mayavadi first, after the changing heart, and Paramahansa Babaji Maharaj doing Leela Smaran, Siddha Mahatma, he is all the time doing his eternal seva, mentally is doing. And one day, the time when Vaishnavdas was already initiated, he is doing bhajan, getting some space inside the heart of Gurudev. Because you can, not a matter of joke, when Sadguru can make a room for you inside the heart, that means you are going to get some stamp, oversanguine. It's not a matter of joke. You know, when Sadguru is going to approve your bhajan, everything, your heart is totally matching with Sadguru, then you are really lucky. So, you can find that Vaishnav Das was Mayavadi, but now by the mercy of Sadguru, Paramahansa Guru, enjoying full kippa. Full kippa and humbleness is so humble, that each and every step he is going to show his humbleness and going to protect the prestige of whole Vaishnav Samaj. It is written. We are less interested about it. It is written in Jaiva Dharma, Jaiva Dharma, Bhaktivinoda speaking. Vaishnav Das was Pandit. Yes, sir, words in Vedanta, everything. But he was Mayavadi. He was totally versed in Shastra. But now, when he is going to get bhakti, those education, everything become different kind of ornaments. Very, very ornament, decorative. All different people coming to fight with Babaji Maharaj, and Paramahansa Babaji Maharaj give the scope to Vaishnav Das to give spiritual argument. I mean, to give judgment. Siddhanta Vichar. From Santipur here, there are so many kind of fight. Who can give judgment? Who can? To protect Sampradaya, to protect the genuine Baba of Sampradaya, genuine glories of Sampradayas, we'll have to come forward. We are going backward. Because we like to prove that we are all great Vaishnav, we have no fighting with him. Arey Maharaj, fighting we need to protect Sampradaya. If you have at all any loveful relation with Sampradaya, if you at all any sadhu, perfect sadhu, so why not you are growing this kind of mood? Why you are not become busy to protect your Sampradaya, whole situation of Sampradaya? For only for cheap pratishtha, lap puja pratishtha, we can sell the soulful Sampradaya to somebody. Is our mood. Now there in Jaiva Dharma, the example I wanted to give to you is that one day Babaji Maharaj in the morning time, very early in the morning, 4:30 or maybe 4:30, Babaji Maharaj doing Harinam and tears rolling down his cheeks, and gradually Babaji Maharaj, going to give indication to Vaishnav Das. Still today, Vaishnav Das not going to know his eternal identity. I am speaking because Prabhupada speaking, giving the right information. And at the same time, sometime some miracle can happen. That I am speaking. It is also true. When Vaishnav Das is there, Gurudev doing Harinam in Madhavilata Kunj, very nice Kunja. And with food, flowers, and nice Madhavilata Kunja, there Babaji Maharaj gradually opening eyes very, not fully, half-opened eyes, and giving instruction to Vaishnav Das. But not speaking Vaishnav Das, going to speak the name of Vaishnav Das, eternal name, with his name, eternal parichay. Hey, Sakhi, manje, you will have to be very careful about your seva. You see, Vrindadevi is going to give indication, instruction. There should not be any impediments, any problem in seva. Radha Krishna is going to take rest and going to break the sleep. Very careful about your seva. Then, through the, this way, Paramahansa Babaji Maharaj, eternally present in eternal Dham, Siddha Swarup. Babaji Maharaj is not material. This Babaji Maharaj suddenly started speaking, giving some instruction to Vaishnav Das by his eternal name. Hey, your seva this. Hey Sakhi, hey Manjari. Hey Sakhi, your seva is this. Be careful about your seva. You see, Vrindadevi, giving some indication. There should not be any disturbance. Then, Vaishnav Das could realize his eternal identity. This also can happen. Sometime, it is rare. It is rare. Sometime this can also happen. That Siddha Mahatma, Gurupad Padmo can directly speak to you in fully absorbing mood, can going to express your mood, seva, everything. That is also possible. Otherwise, usual procedure is there through Harinam, because Vaishnava Das was already fully, you know, Vaishnava Das was not in normal condition. Sevan Mukhi Yuhaya Madhus, his condition was like this. All his sense organ, all his mind, brain, everything, always, you know, eager to serve Aprakita Harinam, Prabhu, he, I know Krishna, I know Dham, Nam, everything, totally. That's why, maybe for this reason only, Vaishnava Das is going to get this kind of facility, otherwise, in general, it is not the procedure. Artificial procedure is not applicable in our life. That spiritual death, we can meet with spiritual death because we are going to take the help of material mind. We can failure, we can get. So, Nathamadagar also going to give, you know, going to give indication that Sri Krishna Chaitanya Daya Karaha Vichar Karile Chitte Pave Chamatkar. And also Nathamadagar speaking in another Kirtan, it is from Chaitanya Charitamrita, another in Kirtan, Nathamadagar speaking, Vichar Kariya Mane Bhakti Ras Ashadane Madhyastha Sri Bhagavat Puran. Vichar Kariya Mane. A Prakita Man, you know, can appear inside and you will have to make balance. Vichar Kariya Bhakti Ras Ashadane to get the taste of Bhakti Ras. You will have to keep Srimad Bhagavadji Mahapuran in middle. Because Bhagavadji Mahapuran is no other than Krishna, and Bhagavadji Mahapuran is the Amal Praman, is the topmost Praman. Also, Bhaktivinoda Thakur, you know, writing in his Kirtan, Namanile Subhajan, for the Sahajya, actually, Bhaktivinoda Thakur writing, Namanile Subhajan Sadhu Sanghe Kirtan. You are never going to admit your gradual promotional procedure. You never wanted to get the actual Sadhu Sangha, Sankirtan. You are going to join those Sahajya, Namanile Subhajan, shown by previous Guru Varga. You are less interested about it. You like to jump. Namanile Subhajan, Sadhu Sanghe Kirtan. Nakarile Nirjane Smaran. Because Prabhupada already saying, Kirtana Prabhave Smarana Haive Sekale Bhajan Nirjan Sambhav. Try to understand. But Prabhupada already writing Vaishnav K. Who is Vaishnav in this Kirtan? Prabhupada going to give us indication that Kirtana Prabhave Smarana Haive. When you are doing pure Kirtan, then this your pure Kirtan can help you to remember everything. You can automatically see a series of lila can come inside your mind. So, procedure shown by Prabhupada is that actually sekale bhajan nijan sambha. You know, kirtana prabhave, by the power, by the influence, by the power of kirtan, pure kirtan. That's why in bhajan rasa also you can find Sei lila karo ar, sei lila chinto ar, karo sankirtan. Srila Bhakti, Bharti Maharaji also used to speak this way. I am also speaking. So, ei lila chinto ar, karo sankirtan. That's mean, all the time you will have to think about that lila, but sankirtan should be condition of sankirtan. Not that you can try Sankirtan, it becomes Sankirtan. Sankirtan is not possible for everybody. Sankirtan means to satisfy Supreme Lord totally. Nam Sankirtan. So, you see, in Bhajan Rahasa, this indication given by Bhaktivinoda Thakur, that ei lila chintuar karo sankirtan. When you can do sankirtan, sammak kirtan, perfect kirtan, or sankirtan means bahubir militva yo kirtanam sa sankirtanam. So many devotees, like-minded devotees, samasila vayanti bhoi, you know, they are going to do sankirtan with same mood. In that case, you can get the excellency of your raganuga bhajan. When outside people there, then Prabhupada Chaitanya Mahaprabhu is going to avoid them. Antaranga lohiya kare naam sankirtan, bahiranga lohiya kare, naam sankirtan, antaranga lohiya kare rasa asadhan. Bahiranga mane, those who are not, bahiranga doesn't mean actually Siva Siva, they are outside, not there. Bahiranga mean when all common mixed populations are there. Bahiranga doesn't mean, bahiranga always means that outside people. But here sometimes you can identify, you can speak to me, Maharaj, when Mahaprabhu doing Sankirtan with Sivas Pandit, everything, he is a bahiranga. No, they are not, they have some separate rasa. So in general, Bhaktivinoda Thakur Phuke, when mixed population present, mixed devotee, in that case Sankirtan is good. And rasa sadhan, Mahaprabhu going to speak the rasa sadhan with Sarup Goswami, Sarup Damodar, you know, according to his own bhava. They are doing this way. So, Eilila Chintuar Koro Sankirtan. When you are going to do Sankirtan perfect, then automatically this Lila Smaran can come. Bhakti Mata writing Kirtan, that doesn't mean anybody can start doing, you know, Raganuga Bhajan and Jam Kirtan. Not that. Everybody cannot do. It's condition there. Prabhupada Bhaktivinoda Thakur speaking. Everything. So, actually, Eilila Chintuar Kare Sankirtan Achire Paibe Tumi Bhava Uddipan. Bhaktivinoda Thakur speaking. If you can proceed this way, very shortly, through your Sankirtan, and you are going to think, you know, smart, you can get Bhava Uddipan. Uddipan means you can get some extra power, uddipan. Uddipan means actually one kind of symptom can be seen. Uddipan means like, you know, Kadamba Bhiksha, Jamuna, going to give you some, you know, extra advantage, feeling, some extra feeling, extraordinary feeling. It's called uddipan. Uddipan means some, you know, what I can say, it can help you to grow your bhava. It's called uddipan. You know, it's one catalytic. Like in chemistry, you can get some reaction going to take place. In that case, something you can add as catalyst. Catalyst means expedite. The reaction can expedite. There is this much I can say. Nothing else. This way, Eilila Chintuar Kare Sankirtan Achire Paibe Tumi Bhava Uddipan. You can get the facility of Bhava Uddipan. You can feel some extra feeling, backing of your feeling, this way. So, Bhava speaking, Nirjan Bhajan is not possible. Kirtana Bhava Smarana Hibe. When you are going to do Kirtan continuously, non-stop, in that case, Kirtana Bhava Smarana Hibe. In that case, all series of lila can come inside your mind, and in that condition, only and only then, you can go for solitary bhajan. Solitary bhajan for bonded soul, not possible. Why Gaur Kishor Babaji Maharaj purposefully want to take place inside public latrine? Why Gaur Kishor Babaji Maharaj wanted to take place inside public latrine so that nobody can disturb him? Because a series of lila he is feeling inside heart, not a matter of joke. This way, under the guidance of pure Raganuga devotees, Bhakta, previous Gauriya Guru Varga, we will have to follow the procedure of bhajan. We cannot jump. So, actually, point is that Nitya Siddha Krishna Prem, Saddha Govinoy, Sobanadi Shuddha Chitta Kareyude. Nitya Siddha Krishna Prem, you cannot get forcefully, you cannot get forcefully, automatically it can appear, you know. Kriti, I can remember yesterday I was discussing that Kriti Shaddha Bhavet Saddha Bhava Sa Sadhan Avida Nitya Siddhasya Bhavasya Prakatyam Hidi Saddhata. Yes, there is a procedure I already told. And if you are going to make mistake, then in that case, it is written in Chaitanya Charitamrita, Bahu Janma Kare Jodi Savan Kirtan Tobutona Pai Krishna Pade Premdhan. Bahu Janma, life after life, Chaitanya Charitamrita is written. In Chaitanya Charitamrita, you can get everything in seed form, everything in details. Nothing there in Goswami Granta which is not available in Chaitanya Charitamrita. So powerful. So Chaitanya Charitamrita Adikhanda, Asta 8 section, it is written, Bahu Janma Kare Jodi Shravan Kirtan Tobutona Pai Krishna Pade Premdhan. So you see, first you can get information, Nitya Siddha Krishna Prem Saddha Gubunai, you get this information. After that, this information is also very important, that Bahu Janma, life after life, you are going to do Savan Kirtan, everything, but wrong way of your Savan Kirtan cannot help you. You are doing aparad. Tabutana Pai Krishna Pade Premdhan. You cannot get Premdhan unto the lotus feet of Krishna. Krishna Pade Premdhan, you cannot get. It's not possible to get. Be careful. This is the procedure. So, Saddho Bhakti Baba, I was discussing. Today I was not satisfied after discussing, but I am feeling very sorry how to represent, because not a matter of joke. And Santo, I was speaking about Santaras. Santaras, when those who are going to Santo Bhakti Ras, you know, Santo Bhakti Ras, in that case, Sadhan Bhakti, you know, Sadhan Bhakti, after that, Bhav Bhakti, you know. So, Santo Bhakti Ras means Bhav Bhakti also. Santo Bhakti Ras, you know, in that case, you can get the feeling of Satchidananda Vigraha, Narakriti Parabrahma, four hand, or Paramatma, Santo Danto, very calm and quiet. No chanchal bhav, very calm, and suchi, very pure, all the time, basi. And also, you are going to take the support of this kind of feeling about Krishna. You know, Narakriti Parabrahma, Chaturbhuj Narayan, Paramatma, and Santo bhav, you know, Danto, suchi, basi. This kind of qualities you can discover in Krishna. It is a supporting factor, Visaya Valamman. And I already discussed today, I cannot, because you can feel bored. I can, little bit I can jump, because you cannot understand. Shanok Sanandan, Sanatan Sanat Kumar, you know, Tapasgan, this kind of. And Gani Gano Mukti Banja, actually, some category I already told yesterday about, I am not going to touch again. And then from Santadas, you know, in Santaran, you know, maybe the Sanchari actually is Shanti Sthai Bhav. Santaras is a Sthai Bhav, he has Sthai Bhav. And with this Sanchari Bhav, which is sometime coming and going to support the feeling of Rasa, you know, Santaras, is called Nirved, fed up. Nirved, you know, sometime expressing some mood, dhriti, praviti, sanchari bhav can come and support. After that, Dasya Bhakti Raj I was speaking, and different categories of Dasya Bhakti Raj I was speaking. Today I cannot speak again, and you will have to. So, now point is that, Dasya Raj, you know, different kind of discussion I should do. Four detailed discussion, it was months after months, impossible. So, ukto bhakta madhe, those who are bhakta, you know, Dasya Bhakti Ras, I already categorically told. So, Bhakti Sakal can be divided into three categories. One is Nitya Siddha and some Sadhan Siddha. And some Sadhak. Sadhak means still today doing bhajan. Trivida, three different kind of Santaras. One is Nitya Siddha, one Sadhan Siddha, one is still today doing bhajan with full mood. So Krishna Charan Dhuli, dust particle from the lotus, and Krishna Prasad, and Uchishta, those all are Bhav Uddivan, catalyst. Catalyst means Uddivan, you can get extra feeling. You know, your heart can get some extra feeling. It's called Uddivan, catalyst. And in this rasa, dasa rasa, agya, palanadi, you will have to carry out the order given by Krishna. And this dasa rasa also I categorically told, sometimes different kind of moods I already told. You know, different kind of mood I already told. Adhikrita, those who are controlled by Prabhu, Swayam Bhagavan, they are getting some special service at Brahma, Sankari, etc. They are called Adhikrita Bhakta. Asrita Bhakta, three different categories, Saranya, Ganichar, Sevanishto, Tamana Saranya means taking shelter ultimately, as Kaliya, Magadraj, Jarasandha, he, you know, kept in jail so many kings in what they were in prison of Jarasandha. They were there. That's called Jarasandha, Avarudha, Rajagandha, they are Saranya. And first of all, they are Gani. After that, getting some inspiration to do bhajan, Sanakadi Muni, etc., Navajogendra. And also, Sevanishto Bhakta, you can get, you know, Sevanishto Bhakta, Chandra Dhajo, Harihar, Bahulasya. You can go through Bhagavan, Tenkandi, you can. Also, there is some division. Uddhav, Daruk, Shuto Devadi, Khatriyagan, O Upa, Upananda, Pavitagupgan, Parishat, they are Parishat Bhakta, Dasya Bhakta, Uddhav, Daruk, Shuto Devadi, Khatriya, Upananda. In this way, you can, different category can be there. In Dasya Bhakta, you can go up to different, up to some final stage of Raga. Dasya, finally you can go up to Raga. There is three different conditions, Prema, Sneho, and Raga. Now, I like to discuss all in details because otherwise you are in confusion, you cannot understand what I like to say. So, up to this point, I like to discuss Prem, Sneho, Rag, but exact translation is not possible. Still, I am trying by the mercy of our previous Guru Varga, keeping in mind their keeper, I am trying to, you know, you can understand, you try to understand Adu Shadhya Tatoha Sadhu Sangha, you know, but clear understanding. You try to understand. Because there is so many secret, you know, information. So, Shraddha, basically I like to discuss, you can get more and more information about it. So, otherwise this kind of Dasa Rasa Sankara, all if you cannot understand, what is Prema? So, basically I like to understand, I like to discuss again. Shraddha means a faith in Supreme Being, Sri Krishna. A strong faith that by serving Him alone, everything else is served wholly and completely. Just like the example I already giving, when we are going to give water into the root of a tree, that example is okay. I don't like to discuss in details. This way actually, you can get that Shraddha, when they are having Shraddha, there is by the association of Sadhu Guru Vaishnava, by his association, you know, previously was a bondage, Shraddha is gradually growing inside heart. First is Komal Shraddha, soft Shraddha. Komal Shraddha means Komal Shraddha means soft Shraddha, preliminary Shraddha. Komal Shraddha any time can vanish. Those who are having Komal Shraddha, soft Shraddha, no rigid foundation, that Shraddha can any time vanish. So somebody putting question, Maharaj, why so many devotees coming in devotional field and they are going away? The answer is that most of them having Komal Shraddha, soft Shraddha, basic Shraddha. Basic Shraddha is unstable, any time can break down. And another is Shastriya Shraddha. After getting association of pure Guru Vaishnava, we are getting stability of mind. Shastriya Shraddha, rigid, you know. That you have a strong faith in Shastra, everything, it is called Shastriya Shraddha. Those who are going to great, those who are going to grow, Komal Shraddha, Komal Shraddha, Komal Shraddha means anytime can break down, you know. So, in this condition, Sadhak, you know, anybody can break down, his Shraddha can break down. So, when the spiritual Shraddha or firm faith is the sheath of bhakti, then it is okay. When your Shraddha is two kind, one hovering still today, Shraddha basically two types, try to understand. That is, basically, basic Shraddha is hovering around mundane plane. Another type of Shraddha hovering around spiritual, you know, platform. Spiritual Shraddha or from Shraddha, from faith is a seed of bhakti. And the other one is not that. Because sometime when you are watching your grandmother going to temple or doing something, you know, doing something, giving water to Tulsi, this kind of, you know, by the habit of your grandmother, you are going to grow some habit. It is called actually soft Shraddha. You are going to follow grandmother. Actually, have no idea why and why, what the reason, what is the reason. You are doing, basically you are doing. It's called actually Komal Shraddha, Mandan Shraddha. So after that you can get Vastavik Shraddha, real Shraddha, which can give you backing in your spiritual life. And it is Shraddha or from faith is the seed of bhakti. Be careful. Bhakti, from Bhakti Sandarbha, I am going to quote this thing. So, Shraddha, you understand basically what is Shraddha, the clear conception. Sadhu Sangha, you think, if there is some sadhu, I can go and sit there and take some prasadam, everything, Sadhu Sangha is over. Not there. Company of sadhus or saints, this means an individual's eager desire to be in the company of sadhu. There is no desire, forcefully you are going there to get prasadam, desire you can sit there. But when out of your mind you want to get sadhu sangha and pure sadhu sangha, you know, this means an individual's eager desire to be in the company of a sadhu in order to learn the method of spiritual practice for God realization alone and not for other purpose. Because we can pay dandavat bancha kalpatarvasya ki pasindu bhavacha patitanam pavanapa vaishnavya. This means Vaishnava is bancha kalpataru. If I pay dandavat with some separate desire, then Guru Vaishnava, so that I can go to foreign country, I can get some money, I can marry a foreign lady, this can onnavilas. This is not. So try to understand what is sadhu sangha. When there is no duplicity inside your heart, you are approaching pure sadhu association, you want to get pure sadhu to learn the procedure of bhajan. For God realization only, alone, not for any other purpose. But who is the sadhu? Now question coming, who is the sadhu? There are so many symptoms of sadhu written there, but still we are so idiot, we cannot realize. Repeatedly, we are discussing, there are so many symptoms of sadhu, so many symptoms. In fifth canto, in third canto, so many symptoms we know from Bhagavatam chapter. So, in general, I try to discuss that the sadhu can have different kind of qualities. A sadhu is kind enough. A sadhu is kind always. He never feel any animosity. Never. He is not going to fight with anybody. He cherishes animosity towards none. He is not going to show any fighting attitude. No, animosity with none, towards none. He is going to bear any amount of trouble coming in his life. Any amount of trouble coming in his life, he is always going to think about you all. He is taking trouble. He is smilingly going to suffer, endure anything. He loves truth. He loves truth as the heart and soul. And how the truth, absolutely, he is going to love the truth from heart. Truth is two types of truth, you know, apparent truth and absolute truth. Anyway, truth, he has a great faith and love for truth. Truth, you know, he loves truth. He never allows any evil thought to pollute his mind. Mental contamination, many times I told, you cannot allow your mental mind to contaminate your heart. Try to follow the procedure of Cheta Darpana Marjanam all the time. Sometime you are in appealing mood saying, Maharaj, I have done some mistake again, I am going to try to rectify myself. But if at all there is mood inside your heart, if you at all want to rectify you, then you can get divine love. I think you have no, that kind of mood is not there. So he never allows any evil conception or thoughts to pollute his mind, heart. Contamination he cannot allow. He looks upon all with equal love. He can have equal sight for all and compassion. He does not entertain any kind of mundane desire. He cannot have, a pure sadhu cannot have any kind of material desire inside his heart. To darken his, you know, because mundane demands coming means darkness can come. Is kama. Agyan tamer naam kohiye koitab. Koitab means cheating propensity. You know, Agyan, Krishnadas Kavidas Goswami writing, Agyan tamer naam kohiye koitab. Agyan tamo, tamagun, agyan. Oh, material desire, this, that, all wrong conception, opposite conception. You know, it is. So, Krishnadas Kavidas Goswami is writing, Agyan tamer naam kohiye koitab. It is called kitab, meaning cheating propensity. Agyan tamer naam. And there is some division. It is written, Agyan tamer naam kohiye koitab. Dharma artho, kam moksho adi eishav. Tar modde moksho bancha koitab pradhan. Jaha huite Krishna bhakti hayanto dhyan. Try to understand. You know, what is written? Bhajan, dharma artho kam moksho. Agyan tamer naam kohiye koitab. Dharma artho kam moksho adi eishav, etc. Dharma, general dharma, misconception about dharma, proper. Dharma, social dharma, so many. I am not going to discuss it. Previous days, all those previous days I was discussing in, you know, detailed discussion. You have to go back and realize. Dharma artho kam moksho. Dharma means this dharma is not, surely not Bhagavad dharma. This dharma is general conception. Dharma artho. Artho means by applying your energy, what ultimate benefit you are going to get, that's called artha. Artham anartham bhavayo nitam. We can say artha is the source of all misery. Artham anartham bhavayo nitam. Shankaracharya speaking. Really so. So, because this artha, if artha has no relationship with Krishna seva, then is anartha. So, dharma artha kam. Kam mean by applying artha, what you are going to gain by putting your energy, that you are going to engage, you know, for getting enjoyment. Kam. Kam and material desire different kind. You are going to fulfill your desire. If you have money, you are going to 5-star hotel, dancing, you are going to take and so many things you are enjoying. So dharma artha kam moksha kam. So these three are the main target. Moksha is also rare. Who is going to ask moksha? Moksha is also rare. Not a matter of joke. Moksha is also rare. You know. Even you cannot find one you know such man who is going to, you know. But be careful. Tar moddhe moksha bancha koitobo pradhan. Moksha bancha, the desire to get salvation, moksha. Impersonal Brahma you can submerge so that no problem can arise in your life, infinity life anymore. But this is wrong. So it is written that dharma dhamma tar moddhe moksha bancha koitobo pradhan. Moksha bancha, the desire for moksha is the topmost enemy in your life. Because you cannot get bhakti. Never you can get bhakti. So this way I am going to explain that there cannot be any mundane desire to darken your heart. He is self-controlled. Is not controlled by anybody. Guru Vaishnava. Self-control means by controlled by Guru Vaishnava. Self-control means there is no, you know, internal urge. Urge means to get something, you know, in unstable condition, not there. Self-control, you know, is stability. You know, it's called self-control. You know, pure character all the time. You know, he remains, you know, long away from any kind of, you know, attempt to accumulate for the future. He is not less interested to arrange something for as his future support. He never want niskinchan or akinchan, you can say. This way, he depends upon Krishna only. Constant remembrance of Lord depends upon Krishna. He is full patient, you know, solemn, magnanimous, and undisturbed even by uttermost provocations and torture, turmoils, anything. He has control over hunger, thirst, lamentation and infatuation, birth and death, everything is not going to. You can remember long ago I was discussing about the symptom of Mahabhagavata Sadhu. He does never aspire after respect for himself. Amani Manot, Niskinchan. But always respectful to others. He is friendly to all. His heart is full of compassion for others. He is fully conversant with the real nature of God. He is totally versed. Sabde parichan isnatam. Conversant means he is totally versed about Bhagavad Tattva Vigyan. You can remember. And Rai Ramananda Mahaprabhu discussion there. Jai Krishna Tattva Betta Sai Guru Hai. Mahaprabhu speaking. You know. Jai Krishna Tattva Betta Sai Guru Hai. You know, it is written. Rai Ramananda Sangvadya. So, he is fully conversant with the real nature of God. He is knowing verse in Bhagavad Tattva Vigyan. He is erudite. To keep company with such a one in person, you know, you have to think, you will have to think thousands of times before getting pure association. If you can get this kind of symptoms in a sadhu, then and only then you can go to get pure association. Otherwise, pure association is really rare at present. Mediocre association you can get, not so pure sadhu, mediocre you can get. But third is that, adu sadhya tatoha sadhu sangha. I already told, preliminary sadhu sangha can grow your, preliminary you are getting some backing, but second sadhu sangha can give you some basic saddha. First basic saddha, you are growing some intensity to serve this, that. Second sadhu sangha, first is shraddha. You can somehow, your grandmother may be doing, chanting something, you are going to imitate, going to give water. This basically you are going to get. I told you, na, that kind of shraddha is hovering about material, mundane world. This way. And second sadhu sangha, when you are getting, you are going to learn the procedure of bhajan, how to do. Third, you will have to bhajana kriya, and then the question of taking shelter under the lotus feet of Guru, Guru Pātva. That's why Rupa Goswami Pāda in Rasamrita Sindhu already told, Ado Guru Padasrayo Tasmat Krishna Dikshadi Shikshanam. I mean, by the glories of your Guru Vaishnava, you are just move, you are just going to feel that this kind of Guru I need in my life. Going to accept Guru or Vaishnava from your heart, it is called Ado Guru Padasraya. You are going to take shelter first. Then you can request him. I already gave the example of Narottam Thakur. Already, you know, he is going to take shelter of Loknath Goswami by waiting for the kripa of Loknath Goswami in the form of Diksha. So, you see, in that case, Sadhu Sangha, Sadhu Sangha, second Sadhu Sangha, you can know the process. This way you will have to do bhajan. After that, after knowing the characteristics of all sadhu, you are going to get this full idea. You are going to grow your, your desire and how to serve. You are learning. After that, Ado Guru Padasrayo and Tasmat Krishna Dikshadi Shikshanam. So, Ado Shadhyata to Sadhu Sangha to Bhajanakriya. And this Bhajanakriya is a vast procedure. Not that Bhajanakriya, I am doing Bhajan, this Bhajan, not that. You have to learn. So I took trouble to go through, I want to discuss all in details so that you can understand Bhajanakriya. It is called a spiritual practice in the stage of bondage condition. When you are in bondage condition, you are going to do spiritual practice. This bhajana kriya is twofold. One is nishtha, having rigidity, and is another is anishchita, arthat, no rigidity there. Slackness in the spiritual practice. There are two different kind of. This slackness in spiritual practice may be due to six different kind of circumstances in your life. So, one bhajana kriya, some so-called sadhu trying his best is with nishtha. And nishtha huite upajaya premettaram. Mahaprabhu wanted to speak, when you are nishtha, nishtha means full rigidity, full faith and full rigidity. Then Mahaprabhu speaking, nishtha hoite upajaya premettaranga. Then today or tomorrow, surely in the way of his bhajan, he is going to get premettaranga, prema he can get. But this bhajana kriya can be divided into two parts. One is nishchita. Nishchita means with stability, stability, rigidity. Another is, no rigidity. This slackness in spiritual practice may be due to six different circumstances. I know you feel bored, but still you will have to learn. Otherwise, no way. You know, Vishwanath Chakravarti writing in his Madhurya Kadambini, there, sometime that sadhak, there is different kind of condition in your life can you can meet in the way of your bhajan. One is utsahamai. Utsahamai means utsahamai, sometimes feeling great, you know, great energy to do it. I must do it. So utsahamai. Utsahamai first, you know, is going to think, you know, utsahamai sometimes gives a very great energy to do bhajan. After that, he is going to lose his energy. And utsahamai actually in English translation, impossible, but our Guru Varga going to show us early zeal in bhakti. Like a child when first attempt to read, he is reading so much. You know, he can read, and a child start, you know, walking, is, you know, when start working, he is working and falling down, walking, again trying. After some day, you're going to get some power to, then, mom, mother, you take me in lap, you learn how to walk. No. This way, utsahamai, first, then ganatarala. Ganatarala means, you know, stickant liquidity, liquidity in dense form. Ganatarala, a translation not possible, a dense form. Then there was a fluid condition, very nice, smooth, but after that, ganatarala. Ganatarala means stickant liquidity. And sometime progressive and sometime reprogressive. Sometime going very bhajan nicely. Sometimes both cannot getting energy to bhajan. And this kind of process of spiritual practice of bhakti, like the intensity and slackness of a student in his studies. Sometimes getting great energy, reading, sometimes, oh, great trouble. Going to lose trouble. So, utsahamai, in the way of your bhajan, you understand. From first is Vishwanath Chakravarti speaking. First endeavor is utsahamai, with great energy started. After that, losing energy, ganatarala. And after that, it is called, actually, you know, utsahamai, ganatarala. After that, buddha vikalpa. Buddha vikalpa is a conflicting condition of mind. Sometime a brahmachari is saying, this is the condition of mort, I should go back to home and marry, and after marriage, also so many our Guru Varga, after marriage doing bhajan, why not possible? This kind. After that again thinking, no. I am getting the scope to stay in mart, Savan Kirtan, so much facility in home, how I can get this kind of facility? So this kind of conflicting condition come, doubts. His heart is always in an oscillating condition. It's called buddha vikalpa. I cannot take time to discuss long, you know, buddha vikalpa. After that, actually, you know, vaisha vishaya sangara. After that, vishaya sangara. Vishaya sangara, it is fighting with his own mind. A devotee fighting with own mind is vishaya sangara. Vishaya sangara, either the fight against the temptation of worldly enjoyments. Sometimes, no, this is bad. I am in renounced order. I should follow this brahmacharya. After that, he goes fighting. He cannot come out successful, fighting and fighting. It's called vishaya sangara. Like in the water, a crocodile going to catch you. You are fighting in water. How to get rid? Fighting going on. The matter in the form of crocodile going to catch you, we are going to get rid of that, you know. In this stage of slackness, the devotee sometimes overcomes all you know, worldly pleasure, everything, try to conquer, sometimes get defeated. Vishaya Sangara. You know, it's called Vishaya Sangara. Niyamakshama. Niyamakshama is we are doing, I must doing, as Purushottam Vrata, I must start taking one prasadam day. After some day, Maharaj, my body cannot permit collapse. Niyamakshama. Then now starting taking so many things. It's called Niyamakshama. I must do 1 lakh harinam. 2 days drink, 3rd day, Maharaj, I'm feeling sleepy. How to do? It's not possible. Okay, I can do half. This way, Niyamakshama. Instability in determination. In short word, because I cannot discuss this big discussion, I need detailed discussion. Otherwise, if your basic conception is not clear, Raya Ramananda Sangha, they should chapter, we should close. In this stage of slackness bhakti, the sadhaka fails to stick even to his strong determination taken. He's going to break. Every day going to make a new determination, every day break. You know, I must get up 4 o'clock, then after that 7 o'clock, getting up. They say, you know, after that, Guru Padmanabha used to speak in and laugh. Niyamakshama, Baba, Niyamakshama. After this, Tarangarangini. Tarangarangini means, in one word I like to speak, suppose you have, if you are not habituated to swim, swimming is not possible for you. So someday, you gone to sea beach and suddenly you are going to touch the sea and suddenly it's a wave coming and taking you away. You are losing your ground. All sands going away, you are floating. And sometimes the, you know, in wave going to throw you here, again you are going to be taken by the water flow, again you are. It's called Tarangarangini. Even when a sadhak, in bonded condition, even when a sadhak is overwhelmed, overpowered by a desire for spiritual advancement, is no, I should make the advancement, and engage in spiritual practices, but he is, you know, taken away, overpowered by the force of tide, of worldly gains, enjoyment, name and fame, again going away, again sometime getting a beach. Oh, now I should do it. This way, you are dancing by the power of wave. Tarangarangini. It is called Tarangarangini. This is the condition. Very, very interesting. You know, very, very interesting if you know all in details. Because life is very short. We have no scope to discuss all in details. Still, something we must discuss. After that, you know, I was discussing about adau shadya tato sadhu sanga ato anatha nibrana ato bhajana kriya. After that, anatha nibriti. Anatha nibriti, anatha nibriti mean when your heart is clean, there is no anartha. I mean, cessation of obstacles and the defects that cloud bhakti, that cover up bhakti. Those obstacles can be divided into 4 parts. Anartha nibriti means now your heart is clean and no defects, no nothing is there going to cover up your bhakti, not going to cover up anartha nibriti. Not now, not going to cover up your bhakti. But there are also different kind of obstacles can be there. First, obstacles arising out of impious thinking and wrongdoings, as well as 5-fold miseries, which are, you know, obstacles raising. Where from these obstacle impediments coming? Impious thinking, not pious, improper and impious thinking. and wrongdoings. You know I should do this way, this way. Still you are following fanciful mind, wrongdoings. So obstacles can anarthanibbiti, you cannot conquer, you cannot get victory over anartha until and unless you are going to know this thing. So anarthanibbiti means to get victory over your maya, everything. Different. So maya cloud not going to cover up your bhakti. This is called anarthanibbiti. These obstacles can be different kind of obstacles can come. Those obstacles are four types of obstacles. Obstacles rising out of impious thinking and wrongdoing, as well as five folds of miseries unknowingly going to put you in trouble. Obstacles coming from your impious thinking and wrongdoings, okay, but still unknowingly going to influence you, unknowingly, you don't know, as well as five folds of miseries going to put you in trouble. One is, you know, avidya. Avidya means ignorance. Avidya, to mistake a changeable and transitory object for an eternal entity. Avidya cannot allow you to get entry into, you know, into Gyanamaya Jagat. Avidya. Avidya is ignorance actually. You know, it can make you foolish. Avidya, always. Because Vidya and Avidya, I already told, both there. So when you are going to get the favor of Sadhuguru Vaishnava, then Avidya can go away, Vidya can manifest. Avidya and Mahamaya, Vidya means Yogamaya, can help you. So Avidya, to mistake a changeable and transitory object for an eternal entity. It cannot allow you to get entry in the eternal world. Avidya, ignorance. Asmita means to misidentify one's own self with one's gross physical body and one's subtile body. I mean mind, intelligence and ego. Asmita. Sometimes you are speaking, you have material asmita, jada asmita. Sometimes Guru Varga used to speak to me or to somebody, you have jada asmita. After many, you have some feelings of your, you know, to misidentify one's own self with one's gross physical body and one's subtle body. I mean, your material mind, intelligence and false ego going to put you in trouble, going to misguide you. It's called asmita. You know, I am a professor. You want to guide me? It's asmita. It's, you know, in agyan, you know. The avidya is ignorant. Asmita, you know. Raga. Raga mean, actually, raga mean, raga, anuraga. What do you mean by raga? Raga mean, you know, in Uriya language you speak, tame rago hauchi. Raga hauchi mean, raga mean the anger. But this raga is not anger. Angry attitude. Raga mean attachment to objects of sense experiences. It's called raga. And when anuraga, we can use this language. And now I am speaking about raga. Because anuraga, this question not coming. Still, by the by, I am speaking. Here only avidya, asmita, raga, this. And anuraga is totally separate thing. When you are going to feel tremendous attraction, irresistible. And daily, same thing you are looking, you are getting new idea and enjoyment. It's called anurag. I can discuss after. So now, anartha nibriti, in the way of anartha nibriti, you are going to get some obstacle. You cannot come out, you know, successful in the way of anartha nibriti effort. So obstacle by impious thinking and wrong doings. This also can be divided into five different parts. Avidya, I already discussed. Asmita, raga, attachment to objects of sense experiences. And desha, Desha is Sanskrit word, Bengali also, Desha means anger. Desha, he is doing Videsh, he is, you know, unnecessarily going to pick up, you know, Videsh again means, you know, Desha means anger against opposition to the enjoyment of the senses. Suppose I am going to put some restriction to some brahmachari or sannyasi. You should not do it. He become angry with me. And he think me enemy. Desha. He started, you know, picking up quarrel with me. He started thinking that I am his enemy because I am going to stop him running wrong way. I am going to stop him running wrong way. So naturally became angry. In Gita, you already know. Dayato vishana pungsang sangasteshu upajayate sangyat sangyat kamaha kamat krodho vijayate. Kamat. Here, have some desire to fulfill. When a desire in the way of your fulfillment of your desire, if some impediments coming, you become angry. Hey! Become angry. It's called raga. Attachment to objects of sense experiences is called, you know, raga. And desha means anger against opposition. Anger against opposition to the enjoyment of senses. When anyway you are not going to get the facility to enjoy fancifully, then desha, who is going to put trouble to you? Don't do it. If Guru Vishnu speaking, they become very angry with Guru Vishnu. They are not allowing us. They are envious with us. Not going to allow me to do this thing. Actually, it is kama. Kamat krodho vijayate. So desha. This way you can develop desha. You know. And after that, avinivesha. Avinivesha in English translation, attention. Knowingly or unknowingly, you have some attention. Or avinivesha. To misconceive one as dead when the physical body and the phenomenal objects of physical enjoyments are destroyed. Avinivesha. Avinivesha means to give special attention. Avinivesh. You know, due to your avinivesh, even if you are going to leave your body, this avinivesh, avinivesh means in one sense, attachment I cannot speak. Attachment means already I speak about, you know, raga attachment. And avinivesh means, you know, your deep feeling, concentration about something which you should not do. Avinivesh. Your avinivesh, wrong avinivesh, wrong concentration cannot allow you to do bhajan, your bhajan. Avinivesh. You are busy with your physical body, physical mind, avinivesh, you are thinking about, you know, material thing. So, this is called avinivesh. An obstacle arising, so first, you know, obstacle first, you know, anarthanibhiti in the way of anarthanibhiti, I already discussed. Obstacle rising out of impious thinking and wrongdoings, and as well as five folds of miseries, which I already have discussed, you know. Second obstacle rising out of pious actions done, either in this life or in previous birth. That's why you can remember Narottama Thakur told, Punna se sukher dham naloyo tar nam. Punna. Then don't try to think about pious activities, because pious activities also is the cause of your bondage. Punyesha sukhe dham naloyo tar nam. Because punna, pious activities, can give you facility to get enjoyment. And follow, punyesha sukhe dham, you can get enjoyment. You know, material happiness. So, Narottama Thakur speaking, punyesha sukhe dham naloyo tar nam. Don't try to speak about punna. We, Gaudiya Vaishnava, less interested about pious activities or sinful activities, because both can cause me bondage. You know, both can cause my bondage. So, this way, obstacle raising out of pious actions done either in this life or previous life, then you are going to get enjoyment. It's also heavenly enjoyment or material enjoyment. This you can get facility. There is also bondage for you. So obstacle rising out of pious actions done either in this life or previous life, which is, you know, great, you know, problem for you. You know, obstacle rising out of 10 offenses done. I already discussed, you can remember, obstacle rising out of 10 offenses done to the name of Krishna. 32 offenses committed in the service of Archana. I already discussed. I'm not going to discuss again. You can go 3 days ago, I was discussing. Number 4, obstacle rising out of bhakti itself. Oh, really? Obstacle rising out of bhakti? Yes. Obstacle rising out of bhakti. You are doing bhakti, but your bhakti is wrong. So, obstacle rising out of bhakti itself. Bhakti uttho. In Sanskrit, we say bhakti uttho. You know, anartho. Anartho can. You are doing bhakti, but inside your heart, you are thinking about, you know, bhakti uttho anartho. Bhakti uttho means raising out of your bhakti. What kind of? You can think about lap, puja, patishtha, money you can get. All. Not bhakti. So, bhakti uttho. You know, this obstacle rising out of bhakti itself is one kind of big impediments in the way of your bhajan. That is a form of non-rigid state of, you know, sadhana or of bhakti. In this way, if you do bhajan in a wrong way, then this kind of obstacle can give you money, position, ever, etc. Not amrita. You cannot get amrita. So bhakti, if your bhakti is wrong, then this obstacle rising out of bhakti itself can put you in trouble. You can get some money, mandan, pratishtha, etc. All different kind of problem can come in your life. Big problem. After there is a complete cessation of, you know, above mentioned fourfold possible obstacles, there are 5 impediments to the practice of elementary bhakti for a sadhak, a devotee in bondage condition, can. Except that, after that, 3, those devotees, I discuss all about that. Still after that, you know, after that, there is a complete cessation of above mentioned, or gone. There, 5 impediments of the practice of elementary bhakti for a sadhak, a devotee in bondage stage, which still, if there is bondage inside, now not siddhavastha, bondage condition still there, then also you can get 5 different kind of problem in your life. What is that? Laya, bikshepa, apratipatti, you know, kasaya, rasashada, Vishwanath Chakravarti were giving in details. Laya means to feel ever increasing drowness. Suppose you are doing Harinam. In course of your Harinam, you are doing Harinam. And in the meantime, you are thinking drowsy, feeling sleepy. Stop Harinam. Again, I am not. See, it's called Laya. Laya means to feel ever increasing drowsiness, you know, while singing Kirtana Bhagavan, while listening Harikatha, drowsiness coming, not going to allow you to do Harinam, not going to allow you to do Kirtan, Harikirtan, or listen Harikatha, big problem. This way you can get some problem in your life, it's called Laya. Bikshepa means scattered. Vikshepa means actually, Vikshep means scattered. Like one compass, you know, if you put in front of some, you know, opposite thing, then the compass, you can get, you know, get some repulsion. It's called Vikshepa. Vikshepa means scattered. And not actually scattered, I should say, and some repulsion, Vikshepa. Vikshepa actually means to maintain mundane association while practicing even the external form of bhakti. It's called Vikshep. You are doing Harinam, but you are thinking about money. You know, you are doing Harinam, you are thinking about money. This way I can get some money. It's called Vikshep. I can get some Patishtha this way. It's called Vikshep. Vikshep means, you know, it's going to, you know, repulsion, scattered. You can get some feedback. So Vikshepa means to maintain mundane association. You are doing bhajan, but internally you have connection with material things. Externally you are doing bhajan. It's Vikshep. It cannot allow you to do proper bhajan. It's called Vikshep. Apratipatti means, actually, you know, disinclination for bhajan or spiritual spiritual endeavor, even when realizing one's, you know, laya and vikshepa. Apratipatti means you are going to understand the first two factors. You are going to understand the first two factors. This way I am going to festival, but still not going to rectify you. Apratipatti, disinclination for bhajana. Still you are not going to rectify. It is apratipatti. And kasaya actually in kasaya mean some mark. Suppose somebody going to put, and somebody going to somebody, if going to chew betel leaf for a long time and spitting on ground. Then if you are going to clean that ground, you cannot clean, because there is kasai, one marking, and it's dirty, you know. It's called kasai. You know, follow, we see. So kasai, instinctively prone to anger. Kasai mean, yeah, sometimes if you can anger, you cannot get control over your, you know, avarice and vanity, etc. It's called kasai, going to put problem in your bhajan. You are doing bhajan, but going to put problem. Because sometimes you become angry. Angry means your bhajan finish. Problem. So anger, avarice, and vanity, etc. And rasasada, it means to think of sensual enjoyments, worldly pleasures, while engaged in Hari Bhajan. Rasasada. You try to understand. Rasasada means still today, you are going to feel attraction, enjoyment, worldly enjoyment you need. You still today, you are doing bhajan, but still, rasasada means to think of sensual enjoyments and worldly pleasures while you are already engaged in Hari Bhajan. Or practice of bhakti. Hari Bhajan or practice, you are doing bhajan, but still you have this thinking of sensual. Your mind going, oh, that day I was in this. So this kind of different kind of, you know, variety I already discussed. Anartha Nibriti and Nishtha, I was discussing about Pakka Nishtha. You know, Nishtha mean, so you can remember, what I, Adau Shadhyata to Sadhu Sangha to Bhajana Kriyata Anathana Vridhi Sat Nishtha Ruchistata. Yeah, Nishtha. Nishtha mean rigidity, firmness in the striving for the unfolding of bhakti, to get bhakti. You want to get bhakti. You don't want to go any compromise. It's called Nishtha. Any amount of trouble can come, in the way of your bhajan, but nishtha cannot throw you away from bhajan. Nishtha can help you to get, you know, in touch with bhakti. Prabhupada speaking actually, and Mahaprabhu speaking actually, nishtha hoiti ekango sadhe kimba sadhe bahu ango. Ekango sadhe kimba sadhe bahu ango. One follow of bhakti, one somebody going to do, or some more, you know, might more be maybe 4 or 3 or 2 or 5. Mahaprabhu speaking, ekango sadhe. Maybe he is doing bhajan, one anga of bhajan he is doing, or many, you know, branches of bhajan, you know, many anga, you know. Still, he can get prema. Nishtha vitu upaja premetarango. If he is going to get nishtha, that ekanga one fold of bhajan he can do, what it concerns to me? He can do two folds of bhajan, or 3, 4, 5 folds, or 9 folds of bhajan at a time, like Ambarish Maharaj, what it concerns to me? But if there is no nishtha, no question of prema. He cannot come out successful with your prema bhakti. Rai Mahasaya is going to speak about prema bhakti, na, with a failure. So nishtha means actually firmness, rigidity in your striving for unfolding bhakti. Nishtha ito upaja premetaranga. So when obstacles of laya, bichapa, kasaya, etc. are almost removed from the path of bhakti, so try to understand. Nishtha means firmness, rigidity in the way of your bhajan, firmness in the striving for the unfolding of bhakti. Whereas when obstacles of laya, bhikshapa, kasaya, you know, kasaya, rasasada, apratipati, everything almost gone, etc., almost removed from the path of bhakti. For such a sadhaka, the steadiness that he then attains is called nishtha. And in this condition, the last sloka of Rasa Leela, Vikriritam bhajavad viridancha vishnu, sadhyanitam anasridhumat atavarnayajya. This sloka I can explain someday. Here, Paramya Kesava Goswami speaking, Prabhupada also speaking, that they almost gone. As the kasai, I mean the marking, you know, some almost gone for them. You know, Vikritam bhajavad viridancha vishnu, sadhyam anusrinva atavarnayajya. Saddhan nitan anusunad athavarnayan. I can discuss this. So there they are speaking, je in Bhagavata also, it is written in Bhagavatam also, you know, what is this? I forget the sloka. It's called, what is that? I forget. I can remember. I can speak. So, steadiness is called nishtha. You know. Bhakti can be, you know. So, this kind of nishtha is also, this nishtha or firmness of bhakti can be divided into two different forms. You know. Nibrito prayasu anarthesu, this kind of sloka, I can remember, I can speak. Now, this also can be divided into two parts. One is steadiness that directly concerns bhakti, which is again of three forms. Steadiness. That directly concerns bhakti, which is again of three forms. Bij, physical, such as worship, etc., in the temple, listening to scriptures, this way, you know. This way, and second is verbal, so physical, verbal, such as chanting of the name of God, telling beads and reading around his glories, you know, verbal such as chanting of the name of God and telling, you know, all useless thing, you know. So verbal, physical impediments there, verbal, and mental such as remembrance and meditation of the divine name, you know, mental, one example, mental, such as remembrance of and meditation on the divine name, transcendental form and beauty, supermundant, limitless qualities, spiritual realm, associates and entourage, and the eternal pastimes of the Lord, mental. Nishtha, different kind of nishtha, you can. And so you see, nishtha divided in two parts, I say, steadfastness directly concerned bhakti, which is divided into three different forms, I will discuss. And the second one, steadiness in relation to things which are favorable to bhakti. No desire, no desire for one's own respect. Being respectful to others. Friendliness and compassion, gratitude, self-control, mental tranquility, tolerance, and such other qualities as are helpful to the development of constancy in bhakti. I mean, flowing bhakti in the veil. So now you understand nishtha, I discuss. Ruchi, ruchi means liking. Or I can sometimes I say test. It's called test. Ruchi means test. So, ruchi means test, liking is called test. When a strong test for listening of the glories of Lord become much more agreeable, favorable, than talkings of mundane things, everything, you cannot bear, it's called ruchi. Without prasadam, you are less interested to take anything, then it's called ruchi. You are growing ruchi for prasadam. And on, this ruchi or test for the singing of the glories of God is of two forms, two types. One first is to pay equal attention to all aspects of bhakti without paying any particular attention to the less importancy aspects of bhakti. I mean, to pay equal attention to all aspects of bhakti is called in general. The another is to feel attraction, to feel agreeably affected for the various, you know, traits of bhakti, keeping in view the more importancy and more keeping in view the more important and the less important aspects of thereof. Actually, you know, to feel agreeably affected for the various traits of bhakti. It's called again, two different ones. Ashakti means attachment. When test for services of the Supreme Lord develops into full-grown maturity, and Lord alone becomes the sole object of life and soul, then such an intensity or you know attachment or spiritual practice of a devotee is called asakti. So this asakti tad guna kshane, whenever you are growing asakti attachment to hear the glories of Supreme Lord, it is a stable desire. You cannot stop yourself. It's called asakti. Asakti is tad basati stale. Asakti, asakti is tad gunakshane. Priti is tad basati stale. Priti means love. Actually, priti, not love, actually what to do. You know, asakti is tad gunakshane. Priti is tad basati stale. When you are going to, you know, you have loveful attachment for living in Dhamma, tad basistali. And Baba, actually, the final thing I am going to discuss, and next day, tomorrow I can, Baba, different kind of Baba. Baba, when the above explained asakti or attachment along with ruchi or spontaneous taste soften the heart and mind and ego, and all reasoning, you know, faculties reach a point of melting the heart is called Baba. You know, Baba, I already discussed in different way through, you know, you can remember, I was discussing about Baba, Bhavan Kure Jane, Adosh, Bhavan Kure Jane. This way you can get ittadayo anubhavaha suryatam kure jane. You can get this way. Now our target is to, I can discuss the rest tomorrow. Now I am going to discuss one vital point. Our avalamman, visayalamman and asraya avalamman, asrayalamman and visaya alamman, asraya alamman mean, you know, those who are going to take shelter, asraya alamman. Without Krishna, we are not going to support. Krishna is the only object for which we are feeling Baba. This is called Vishaya Alamman, Krishna. And we are actually asraya, devotees are asraya. Now this Krishna going to stay in Vrindavan, and Krishna going to stay inside Vrindavan. Araddha Bhagavan Vajasastanayasta Dhamma Vrindavanam Ramma Kachidapasana Bhajapati Vargena Jakalpita. I can discuss after. So try to understand Vrindavan and total paraphernalia, etc. And specially for Gaudiya devotees, those who are having Madhur Rasa Bhakta, for them this. And for other Rasa Bhakta, I mean Shanto, Dasho, Vatsalya, Madhur, and Vatsalya, and Shaksha, you will have to Shaksha, Vatsalya, you will have to discuss. All center point is Krishna. Now this Krishna is going to stay inside Vrindavan, nowhere else. Jiva Goswami was speaking, Krishna only staying inside Vrindavan. Mara, we already watched the Vrindavan, from Vrindavan Krishna gone? No. From Vrindavan, Vrindavanam parityajyo kadapi nandanandanam Krishna kadapi annato nagacchati. Kadapi, never going. But it is one kind of, you know, secret, you know, thing that Krishna want to, Krishna always want to increase their bhava, increase their feeling. Feeling of attachment is there. That's why Krishna get banished from us. Actually, Krishna, if we think about our Krishna is 16-year-age, we want to worship Krishna, adolescent, and after that, you know, first of all, actually, we will have to, you know, 5 years, up to 5 years, it is called Kumar, adolescent, you know, it's called actually childhood, you know, Pancham Varsha Kumar, Kumar Achet Prago Dharman Bhagavatani Ho, Pulladma speaking, Kumar is 5 years of age. Is very small age, you know, boy. And up to 10 years is called adolescent. Adolescent stage, up to 10 years. And from 10 years to 15 years is called Kishore, you know. Kishore, I mean, you know, Kishore is called. After that, actually, young age, Jovan. Jovan is full-fledged. So this way, but Krishna anyway not going to stay there for a long time. It is up to 10 years, 8 months, Krishna was there. Then how it is possible that we can worship Krishna, you know, Kishore Krishna? Samo eva param rupam, bayo kaisharakam dheyam. You know? Bayo kaisharakam dheyam. You know? Adya eva pararsaha. This sloka, I can discuss tomorrow, so that you can understand. But half discussion is not good. So, tomorrow I can discuss. So, anyway, what is the main reason? Whereas, you already speaking that up to 10 years, 8 months, Krishna, we can see Krishna inside Vrindavan. After that, Krishna gone to Mathura. But Jiva Goswami speaking, never Krishna going anywhere. Krishna is always there inside Vrindavan. But still, to grow our tenacity, to grow our, you know, that's why Krishna playing that way. Anyway, we can calculate up to this point that Krishna going to leave Vrindavan, going to Mathura at the age of 10 years, up to 10 years, and 8 months Krishna there. Then how we can support this kind of judgment? Then Gosai Baba speaking that you should understand this way that Vayo Kaisharakam Dheyam, the age factor 16 years, we are going to worship, but 16 years are not there while Krishna was there. But now Jiva Gosai Baba giving argument, giving Siddhanta, that you should understand Krishna is the son of a king. Radharani is the daughter of a king. A daughter of a king, a son of a king, their bodily, you know, development is too much. I can show you, can come to Punjab. One boy of 10 years. Maharaj, it seems 16 years. Uribab. So, growth, bodily growth. So this way, Gosai Pad giving this Siddhanta, though Krishna gone at the age of 10 years, 8 months, this, that, but our calculation is on practical basis. It's more practical to think this. Krishna, when going to leave Vrindavan, by that time, Krishna got full maturity of body, full, for attractive for women. Very good, you know, Kishore, adolescent. You know, it's called Kishore boys. You know. So this way we must calculate the when Krishna leave Vrindavan going into Mathura, that by that time Krishna bodily growth, the growth of body of Krishna was enough to understand, just like 16 years boy, or more than that. Similar solution we can find with Radharani. So our Tikaka, those who are giving judgment, you know, note, commentary speaking, at the age of 7 years, in Vaishakh, in the month of Vaishakh, in 7th year, Krishna already started exhibiting his Kishore Leela. Krishna already started, that's why Bastaran Leela, etc., you know. 7 years, I already discussed, you know, you can remember. So, at the age of 7th, in Vaisakh Mass, they already Krishna started exhibiting too much, you know, growth of body. So, this way we can get adjustment, no question of fighting. So, Krishna is the total center point of all our this discussion, and Mahaprabhu also wanted to get total information about Radha Krishna, Krishna and Radharani, and ultimately Mahaprabhu wanted to hear all about the secrecy of Radha Baba, In between Mahaprabhu can ask, you please speak about Krishna Tattva, Radha Tattva, and what is the Baba of Radha Rani, how, what the best possible way of expression we can see by Raya Mahasaya. But today, up to because you can, your brain can feel bored, so gradually you can discuss. But all other discussion I don't like to discuss, it will take long time. So, vital points in the way of your bhajan, I must discuss, I cannot avoid. So, adodanam dantai ridam jache punaha punaha simadapu rupapadam ujadhuli sang janma janmani adodanam strino dantai ridam jache punaha punaha Simadara Simadrupa Padam Bujodhuli Sang Janma Janmani Vanchakalpaturvasikipa Sindhu Bhavisha Patitanang Pavanabhavishna Vyo Namun.